Hey, my beautiful faces. How y'all doing? How y'all feel about this Kodak situation? It really irks the hell out of me, and this is why.
You know, in Kodak's so-called irrelevant, lame-ass, no-given apology, he said, shout out, go out to dude. You said you look up to Nipsey, so shout go out to dude? He did more than shout you out. He gave you love. Look at what he wrote on his motherfucking Twitter. Are you serious? And this was back in August 18th or whatever, 2017 at 11:28 a.m. on Instagram. He shouted you out and told people to go grab at Kodak Black new shit. Strong emoji. So you wouldn't have pulled this if he was here. You'd wait till I was gone to try to, you know, think you gonna get with his woman. We all got dreams, nigga. We really do. But yeah. Crazy. This brother right here, Frederick Joseph, is speaking the peace. He's speaking the real. Oh my God, I won't get into what he's saying. I just listened to it. I'm on Twitter, like I said. This is AEP. Let me see. Many of you say you ride for Nipsey. Well, where is that energy against Kodak Black? Exactly. He disrespected not only Lauren London, but also Nip before he's even in the grave. Sad but true. Let's get into what he said.
London, he was already an accused rapist. So, that's on you.
Start that again.
I don't know why all of you continue to support Kodak. His music's trash. And before his comments about Lauren London, he was already an accused rapist. So, that's on you if you're surprised that a piece of shit is acting like a piece of shit. But all of you who were jumping to conclusions about people around Nipsey and saying you're gonna come see people and fuck people up, have that same energy for Kodak. If you was the person who was talking about, oh, anybody that got something to say about Nipsey, all right, so keep that same energy. Kodak then disrespected Nipsey before the man's even in the grave, and y'all are like, oh, well, it's not that serious. What's up? You was real a second ago, right? Like, what's up? You ride for Nipsey, right? What's up? That shit was wild disrespectful. Kodak Black is a piece of shit.
Hey, people, I'm gonna read to you guys what Big Boy said. As most of you may already know, Kodak Black has been banned from one LA station, Power 106, where they play hip hop and R&B music. He's been banned from there. Big Boy is a very good friend, you know what I'm saying, or whatever, of Nipsey Hussle, God rest his soul. And he had a lot to say regarding Kodak Black. It's not even an apology when you say, Lauren London, I'm sorry, but I didn't do anything. Be a grown up and be accountable for the shit you say. You said you want to, you know, do for the people. You want to, you know, give back like Nipsey does. So that can make her look at you where your exact words. That is pitiful and pathetic. And I think it's morbid too. You wait till the man leave this world. He's not even in the ground to try to get at his woman. That shows what kind of spine you lack. You know what I mean? So let me get into what he said. And it's pretty long and it's straight to him. I think he kind of cracked his face in a lot of areas. So this is what he had to say. I won't disrespect my timeline posting a pic of Kodak Black. However, I will say I'm not here for the blatant disrespect and fake ass apology. To disrespect the king Nipsey and the queen Lauren is where I draw the line. Hip-hop has been very disrespectful lately. Not only is this disrespectful to hip-hop, but this is disrespectful to a beautiful human being, spirit, and a legacy. Sometimes I feel a certain way, but I don't publicly speak out. I just don't fuck with the person, place, or thing. This one I can't just keep in on a personal chill. I've been a child of hip-hop for a long time. Hip-hop raised me and I've raised hip-hop. I'm not new to this or fake with this. I'm a soldier. I'm not just phone taps and funny interviews. Check my pedigree. Okay. I will not stand by and let Kodak Black come between an alliance I have with a dear friends. Nipsey honor cannot be disrespected like this. He will be absolutely right. We must put a shield around at Lauren London and his entire family. We can't allow these things to happen. Nipsey wouldn't. We look the other way and forgive too easily. I agree with that. I am black man first, and I love all that deserve my love. I'm with unity. However, we must discipline our own as well. This isn't about radio or dropping records that's been done. This is about protect legacy and holding people accountable. Amen to that. This may not change Kodak Black now, but I pray it changes his or someone's future. For all of those out there that want to disrespect and play with royalty, I advise you to think thrice. Long live the spirit, knowledge, and wisdom of Nipsey Hussle. This has to be the standard forever. The marathon continues. And he put in parentheses, I'm blocking the bullshit for now. Try me. He is not playing around. And this is the picture he put, because like he said, he's not going to disrespect his timeline with Kodak's face. I know y'all probably hear that. You know what I mean? And I can't apologize for whatever the fuck is going on outside my house. Can't do that, not going to do that. It's life. But that was my alarm. Damn, everything going on at the wrong time. Let's get into the rest of what I had to say.
You know what? Before Nipsey speaks, he's, you know, right. He taught us, you know what I'm saying, or told us how to deal with clown shit, and he is a clown motherfucker. Kodak is, because even with the apology, it's like Lauren London. I apologize, but I didn't do nothing. That's not an apology. It's no buts or I didn't do nothing. None of that. It just puts fuel to the fire, but you already been banned from LA. Hi. I know you ain't going to attempt to come out here. You're not all the way with it like that. You don't want that kind of pressure. You don't want that smoke. You don't want that. You stupid. Stupid and so freaking disrespectful. You know what I mean? Disrespectful as hell. But let's get into what Nipsey say about dealing with clowns.
It's like the public should not even react to clown shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You feel me? We shouldn't even.
And he would be right about that.
The public should follow the real niggas.
Black, that's what you were working on. April 5th, it was announced that you were being charged rape.
Put the dude on goofy time and just let him sit over here and do what he's doing until that shit expires. Because it always going to self-destruct, clearly.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
So, and here we are.
It's like the public should not even react to clown shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You feel me? We shouldn't even. The public should follow the real niggas. And the real niggas ain't reacting, so y'all don't react.
Exactly.
Put this shit on. Put the dude on goofy time and just let him sit over here and do what he's doing until that shit expires. Because it always going to self-destruct, clearly.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
So, and here we are.
He's been a troll. Like, he's been problematic. He's been a reckless troll that has a problem with dark-skinned women and Lil Wayne. Cluck-headed ass looking like a shit emoji. Is that not amazing what his face was just moving and all this beautiful talent and love and time and passion people are putting into gifts and dedications and, you know, of all kind, from dresses to jackets to braids. Man, I'm just so amazed. That shows you how much love and compassion we have for this beautiful man that just brought so much to hip-hop in our lives. Man, you did so much for us, and we appreciate you more than words can say. Rest up, neighborhood Nip. We love you.